Been enjoying meeting fans at the event.
I do. They're wonderful, friendly folks, and it's never too crazy, which is what I like. And I don't mean the people, I just mean the crowds, which is sometimes hard to do. Everyone sort of comes in at a normal pace, and everyone's basically kind of relaxed, and I like it.
The Last Starfighter is one of those films that has grown over time. People, you know, have such a fondness for it. Why do you think that is? What do you think the magic of that film was?
I think it was a good idea. Basically, I think it was a good idea, and I think it was well directed and well written. And I did my best. I thought Kathy was great. I thought Press was great. I thought Dan was great. Everybody that was in it. I don't know. I just think it's a good idea, and it had the right tone. A lot of people like that. They like the tone. And it sort of has the distinction of being the CGI, bit of a groundbreaker for the old CGI, or at least one of them, one of the very, very first ones. So a lot of people get excited about that, since that's become such a massive component of movie making nowadays.
Are there things that make you smile the most when you look back on that production now?
Well, let's see. A lot of stuff that is off camera never makes it onto the screen. And I had a great time with everybody. I liked the scenes where I was playing the beta unit, and I was like rolling around in the sleeping bag with Kathy and, you know, being a dork. Like more of a dork than most teenagers would be. That was funny. And I liked working with Robert Preston, of course, and Kathy. I loved working with Kathy. And that's all I can. We only shot for 38 days, so it was a pretty quick shoot. And most of it was at night. So we shot, we'd show up at work at 6 o'clock, and we go home at 6 o'clock in the morning. And so, remember doing the Death Blossom and almost losing my lunch.
You've talked about Kathy quite a bit. She's sitting next to you today. How nice is it to be reunited with her today? And can you talk about why she was such a wonderful co-star to be blessed with back then?
Well, because she, her acting was so clean and simple and non, and she's a very lovely person, and so we had good chemistry on set. We didn't really know each other, so it was just fun. It was just that part of it was really easy to do, and it was a very sincere script. We didn't have to do any really goofy stuff that people have to do a lot of times. It wasn't over the top. It was just kind of, it had the right blend of comedy, I think, and sincerity. I have a good friend who said he owned the VHS, which most people saw it on VHS or DVD or, cable or something. They didn't really see it in the movie theater. And he said he was like, we'd watch it every day and build a fort, and pretend like he was like flying the thing. And I think that's probably my favorite story. Well, at least the first one that comes to mind.
Kevin, it's amazing to have you with us at Showmasters. You've been enjoying meeting fans here at Comic-Con. Oh,
it's been fantastic. The fans are wonderful here. It's been a steady flow of enthusiastic, wonderful people. And we're all sweating together in this London heat. But it's fantastic. Mostly what I get with films like The Last Starfighter or Night of the Comet is how important these movies were to them as kids in such a pivotal time in their life. A lot of the kids saw these films when they were, or a lot of their adults now, saw these films when they were, young teenagers, and maybe this was the first film that they got to see by themselves. So the film sort of stuck with them, not only in terms of the story that they could relate to, but even just the time in their life that they saw it. And so all these years later, 30 years later, it's so, I'm so grateful how they hold these films close to their hearts still. And that's one of the biggest comments is how, you know, this is my favorite movie of all time. It holds up today. You were my first crush a lot from The Last Starfighter. Or in something like Night of the Comet, you know, the two leads were young female girls that could actually defend themselves in an apocalypse, which is unusual. You know, you don't see that very often, but it's great for girls to see that kind of thing. So we have the best fans. Well, it means everything, really. I mean, as an actor, I guess that's sort of why we do what we do, you know, that it has some sort of an impact on people. Shooting the film itself was just an amazing experience. A lot of people say, did you know when you were shooting The Last Starfighter that it was going to be this big thing 30 years later? And of course not. You know, I certainly didn't think about that kind of thing. So when I found out how impactful it was years and years later, first of all, I was amazed, and then I had to try to wrap my mind around it. I mean, it was a wonderful experience as an actor, just shooting the movie, but I realized that these kind of movies, they don't have to be crazy, complicated, action-packed things. They can be simple stories about simple people with big dreams, and that has an important effect on an audience.
Wonderful co-star Lance is sitting beside you today. Probably a slightly awkward time to ask this, but what was he like to work with? And was it a different experience when he was playing himself and playing his beta unit?
It was a different experience, actually. He was so very different. He nailed it with the beta unit thing. It was very cute. Yeah, we've stayed friends all these years. I mean, I lived in L.A. when he was living in L.A., and he's lived in New York while I'm living in New York, and we go back and forth. We see each other every time we're in town. We're very, very good friends. And that says something as well, I think. I remember auditioning with him for this movie, and there were much bigger names auditioning for it than we were, but we had a real kind of a chemistry. We just clicked, you know, oops. we sort of clicked, and I guess, you know, Nick Castle, the director, and everybody else kind of felt it, so, and we're still really good friends today, and that says something, I think.
Fans must tell you that they have favorite moments from the film, favorite scenes. Do you have favorites? Are the ones that you're especially proud of when you look back now, you think, oh, that makes me smile the most?
Oh, yeah. I love the scene by the lake, where he's the beta unit, and he's making all these bizarro comments, and finally I just like, ugh! And he gets shot, and there's this little splurt of, he's trying to explain to me that he's a beta unit, there's this splurt of green stuff that comes out of him, and then he takes off because, you know, we're being attacked or whatever. I love that scene, that was really, really fun. And then one of my favorite scenes also is after the beta unit, drives the truck into that pod. I look up into the sky. It's so dramatic. I love it. So romantic. I look up into the sky and the wind is blowing, and I look up and I say, I love you, Alex Rogan. It's much better acting, I think, in the movie.
It was fantastic in the movie, and it's even better in person.
Yes, that's like my favorite line.
I think when people celebrate these films, they use that phrase, cult classic. I'm curious what that label means to you, and how does it feel that so many of the films that you're involved with at that point in your career have kind of attracted it over the years?
I'm not really sure how to take that, because I sort of feel like cult classics are so much more gigantic, and I feel like the ones that I mean, Weekend at Bernie's has become sort of a cult film, but it's bigger somehow. Night of the Comet and The Last Starfighter are such sweet, kind of quiet, innocent movies, and cult classics, it's almost like, is it really that? But I do know that the fans of these movies are diehard fans, and they have such affection and have such respect for the movies, too. So, you know, I think The Last Starfighter was a wonderful experience. I mean, it was one of the very first movies I did in the States, United States, and it was just terrific. I mentioned Nick Castle before, the director. This was just a a passion project for him, and you could tell. And when you're on a set, there's always that trickle-down effect from the person in charge, really sets the tone. And it was so much fun to go to work every day. So that really stands out for me. But honestly, and this sounds sort of pathetic, but everything that I've done, I've enjoyed in different ways. I never take it for granted. I love playing completely different characters all the time. There's always something that makes it just genuinely a wonderful experience. So, you know, I would say that everything that I've done, I've had moments of just like, oh, this is the best thing ever. I wish you could be here. I have a Facebook page that I'd love you to join, and I keep you up to date on everything that I'm doing, and also any kind of information or news stories or anything that about what might be coming up, or like there's a chance now that they're going to do a sequel for The Last Starfighter, so stay tuned for that. And that all that information will be on my Facebook page. So join Catherine Mary Stewart on Facebook, and I respond to messages. I'm on it every day. I have somebody helping me just in case I'm out of town like I am now. That's how I would say stay in touch. I'd love to be in touch with all of you.
I said that was my last question, but you can't tell me that there might be a sequel to The Last Starfighter and not explain that. I mean, how likely is that? Is that something that is in development? Is that something that would involve you and Lance? You have to give me some info.
Well, honestly, it's just something that has been talked about a lot over the years, decades. I mean, a decade ago, Nick was talking about a script that he'd written, and Lance had even written a script. And they were trying to get it. There was something to do with the rights to the story. Apparently, that's being resolved. I heard that today. Today I heard that. And so the chance of a sequel, nobody really wants to do a remake, from what I understand, which is, I think that's better as well. But the sequel, it's a big possibility. It's getting closer and closer, so stay tuned.